do not speak Spanish, so I won't embarrass myself. My name is Veronica. I'm a PhD student at the Universidad Transmontial de Fur, and I'm bringing you my talk about the karyotype of Miotino bentoni, a first step towards chromosome evolution of the species. So, as you know, Miotino bentoni is a medium-sized bat that eats insects, and some of the features that distinguish Dobentoni from other bat species is the fur that is characterized as a brown gray to a slightly red dark browns on the dorsum and silver gray to white on the belly. Other features of Dobentoni is their large foot that they use to hunt their species, and Dobentoni is the unique trolling bat species strictly associated with riparian habitats in Portugal, so that's one of the reasons why we brought and we did this study with Miotino bentoni. Miotino bentoni is not currently threatened. It's classified as a least concerned species. However, it's important to amplify our knowledge about it, and if needed, we need to act in their conservation. Cytogenetics is important to evolutionary taxonomic and phylogenetic studies. I brought to you this image here on the left, where we can see two subspecies of Miotino bentoni. And I must refer that this karyotype that I'm going to present, it's only about Miotino bentoni, Dobentoni, and I did not have the time to bring you the karyotype of Miotino bentoni natalina, that is the darkest one on the right. So our work had the main objective of obtaining the karyotype of Miotino bentoni dobentoni, and this was the methodology that we used. First, we need to catch the animals, so we used the mist net technique. You can see and you know how this works. We assembled the net, then the animals are caught by the net. And then we did a biometric collection of the data. We weighted the animal and we measured the forearm of the animal. And finally, we collect a 3 millimeter punch biopsy that we used to establish a primary cell culture. This is very crucial. When we collected the punch, we need to use a specific medium to keep the tissue hydrated, and we need to use antibiotics and the antifungi, or else when we put the tissue in culture, we will have a lot of contamination and we need to put that in the trash, basically. After we establish a primary cell culture, our priority was to cryopreserve the cells. We want to have a bat cell bank with all the species in Portugal too for the studies, because having cells we can obtain proteins, we can obtain RNA, we can obtain DNA, and we can do another stage because we have living cells to do whatever we want. Afterwards, we did chromosome preparations and we did C and G banding. These are the results. In the left we have the C banding, and on the right we have on the left we have the G banding, on the right we have the C banding. And you ask me, why do we need to do banding? Because banding will allow us to know which chromosomes are which. Right? So the next step that we need to do after we obtain these metaphases is to pair the chromosomes into pair 1, pair 2, and etc. C banding will allow us to complement the information that the G banding give to us, because C-banding stains the centromeres, and this also tells us a lot about the chromosomes, because now we know that these chromosomes here, by G-banding, we know that that's the pair 1, 2, and 3, because they have a similar pattern of banding, and we also know the orientation of the centromere, because we have the result from the C-banding. And here we have it. The karyotype from Miotino bentoni dobentoni was reported to have 44 chromosomes before, but it was never presented as we see see it here organized. And it's the chromosome, the karyotype is very consistent with the most of karyotypes of the meiotic species. They all have 44 chromosomes generally. Some there are some exceptions, but generally they have 44 chromosomes. What we can see here also, because we did the sibling, is that pairs 1, 2, and 3 are mesenteric, which means that the centromere is in the middle of the chromosomes, as well as pair 13. We have, in this case, we use the male individual, so we have the Y and the X chromosome. Since the karyotype was not known before, if we started with a female, we didn't have a way to know if the pair of sexual chromosomes, because they have two X chromosomes, was in fact a pair of sexual chromosomes or a pair of autosomes, that are the chromosomes that are not sexual. So, what? Why is this karyotype important? First, the karyotype of meiotis Daventoni was never presented before, at least that image that I showed previously, the number of chromosomes was already known. It's important because knowledge itself, people tend to think that knowledge needs to have direct application, but I think that knowledge itself should be a reason. And because using karyotype, we can aid a lot of studies. We can aid studies species, like identification of species. We can aid sequencing. There's nowadays there's a big project that are trying to sequence all the genomes of the bats existent in the world, and having the karyotype helps assembling the sequences from sequencing studies. And by having the chromosomes and having the karyotype, we can infer evolution relationships between species. So it's very important to have karyotypes. What's next? So first we want to obtain and compare this karyotype here presented with Meiotis Daventoni and Natalini, to see if there's anything in karyotype that can tell us, okay, these are two different subspecies, or maybe we cannot see that by the karyotype and we need to do molecular assays. We want to have the karyotype of all the bat species present existing in Portugal, because if you do a research and you go and see which karyotypes are available in the internet, there's a lot of karyotypes that I have not described yet, so we wanted to do for all species in Portugal. And we want, and this is the goal of my PhD, that is analysis of the mobilome genome, that are a set of DNA sequences that are presented in species, and they can move from one end of the genome to another end, they can interrupt genes, and there are a lot of consequences from their mobility. So we wanted to do an analysis on these elements and see, for example, if a mobile element is in the middle of a gene connected with the color of the fur, if that animal will have a different fur, for example, or a pattern of fur different. So I want to thank my supervisors, the team. I want to thank to the scientific committee for choosing my presentation, and the ANSE for the scholarship to come here, and also Sr. Paul Bach for providing these images that you can see here, and all of you for your attention.
Thank you, Veronica. ¿Alguna pregunta? Any question?